plunged into the water after a container ship hit and destroyed the Francis Scott Key Bridge.
It's unclear how many trucks or cars were on the Francis Scott Key Bridge when it collapsed.
There were likely multiple people on the bridge at the time of the collapse, and that as a result, multiple people were in the water.
Baltimore City Fire Chief James Wallace saying one person rescued said they were okay and refused treatment. The other was in critical condition. They're still looking for others who may have perished in the collapse. Andy Field, ABC News.
CNN reporting President Biden has been briefed on the collapse. The FBI also investigating what caused the boat to steer so far off course. The Fond du Lac County Sheriff's deputy who shot a man last year will not face any charges. Investigators say Deputy Blaine Evans involved in a chase with Kyle Massey, who had been being investigated for sexual assault last October. Investigators say Massey got out of his car with a gun. He and Evans began shooting at each other. As he ran away after the exchange, authorities later determined he died by suicide. Muskego police, meanwhile, need the public's help locating individuals destroying mailboxes. Police are looking for a pickup-style truck with plow on the front that they believe is involved in destroying mailboxes in the Big Muskego Estate subdivision and along Old Loomis Drive. Any photos or home camera footage from Saturday, March 23rd between 2 and 4 a.m. is being requested by Muskego police. And the White House says it's disappointed and perplexed by the Israeli government's decision to cancel a planned visit by officials from that country.
Israel made the decision to pull the visit after the U.S. abstained from a vote at the U.N. Security Council and allowed a resolution calling for an immediate humanitarian ceasefire in Gaza to pass. The Israeli decision, another sign of fraying U.S.-Israel relations. President Biden has already urged Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu against mounting an offensive in Rafah, but Israeli officials appear to be moving ahead anyway, saying a military operation there is key to defeating Hamas. Jay O'Brien, ABC News, Washington.
Time for news about your money, the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. At this hour, the Dow is basically even from yesterday at 39,313. Meanwhile, the S&P 500 up 15 points to 5,233, and the NASDAQ is up 87 this morning to 16,472. Annex Comprehensive Wealth, Annex Private Client, Annex Ignite. Financial planning at every level. Details at annexwealth.com. Bucks and Lakers tonight. We'll have that plus the roads in your five-day forecast up next. Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time 904.
This report is sponsored by Diamonds Direct. Your love, their passion.
Hey, honey, I'm home.
Bob, I just hung up with Joe. It's the fourth time he's called this week. He says he's worried because for the first time in 12 years, you didn't buy my anniversary jewelry from him.
You didn't tell him, did you?
No, I didn't tell him how we made the switch to Diamonds Direct and how much I love my new diamond ring or these incredible diamond stud earrings you got me either.
Bob's gonna go nuts when he finds out. But I can't believe how all these things he used to say about Diamonds Direct just aren't true. And the prices are a lot better than his.
Yeah, and what I love is the free service at Diamonds Direct. I can get my jewelry cleaned anytime. And everyone there is like family.
Are you getting all you deserve from your jeweler? You might be surprised. Maybe it's time to make the switch to Diamonds Direct for guaranteed better value, selection, service, and quality.
If he comes up on the caller ID, just don't answer it.
All right, but we can't keep dodging him. You know we're going to see him at the family reunion.
Yeah, I know.
Diamonds Direct. No middleman, no pricing games, no compromises. Get details and showroom directions at DiamondsDirect.com.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercier here. I've got a great trip coming up this Christmas. I want you to be with us. It's Magical Christmas Markets. Five nights in Innsbruck, the capital of the Alps. We'll take in a horse-drawn carriage ride, make traditional strudel, and spend lots of time shopping in beautiful, historic Christmas markets throughout Europe. It is going to be special hunting for those treasures. I've got a beautiful brochure. I'll send it to you. Shoot me an email, john.mercure@wtmj.com. John.mercure, M-E-R-C-U-R-E at wtmj.com. Magical Christmas Markets. This December, won't you come with us?
We all share the same roads, but when an accident happens, we don't always share the same consequences. Big trucks can cause big damage. Injuries can be severe and may require a lifetime of care and compensation. Call Gruber Law Offices today. We can help you from the safety and comfort of your own home. Our virtual sign-up process is quick and easy. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All Sports Desk. The Bucks are back at it tonight. They take on the Lakers. LeBron James doubtful for tonight's contest. Our coverage gets underway at 6 o'clock right here on WTMJ. Checking the roads, your WTMJ Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic. We've got a slow spot right now on 894 West right through that construction zone. That's adding about 5 extra minutes on your ride from the Mitchell to the Hale. Also got a crash from earlier still being worked on 94 East right near 35th Street on the exit, and that's slowing things down through the stadium. A couple extra minutes on your ride from the zoo into downtown. Also, we've got a crash near Mitchell as well on that stretch. And the right shoulder is still being worked on 43 North at Locust due to a crash there. That's backing things up through the construction on 43 from about Hampton Avenue down to that crashed site.
Traffic is sponsored by the famous Fox and Hounds restaurant near Holly Hill.
Buy one dinner, get one free tonight at the historic Fox and Hounds Supper Club, including steak and lobster. And desserts are buy one, get one free. Tables are open, foxandhoundsrestaurant.com.
Your WTMJ 5-day forecast for today. We'll see rain picking up again later this afternoon. Rumbles of thunder also possible, a high of 54. Could see some very high winds as well, up to 40 miles per hour, 26 and mostly cloudy tonight. Cooler and clear on Wednesday, 42, 47 Thursday. Chance of rain late Friday. Going to be a cooler at the lake day, 45 on the shore, 54 inland. Morning rain Saturday and 48 degrees. Right now in Madison, light rain and 49, 46 in Green Bay. Mostly cloudy and 48 in Waukesha and in Milwaukee. Scattered showers and 50 degrees. I'm Adam Roberts, Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Times 908.
Good morning, Wisconsin. So let's pour that coffee and talk to some experts about what's going on in Milwaukee, Madison, Washington, and beyond. Broadcasting live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at The Avenue in beautiful downtown Milwaukee. It's the Political Power Hour on WTMJ. Here's your host, Steve Scafidi.
Should we talk about the government?
All right, welcoming one of our regular guests on the Tuesday edition of the Political Power Hour, James Wiggerson, great political writer, joining us this morning. Hi, James.
Hi, Steve.
So let's get to it. Mike Gallagher, since we last talked, has decided to leave office. First it was, I'm not going to run for re-election. Now I think you set a date, whether it's April 19th, I think is that date. Interesting development in this story. So we're going to explore it in a couple different ways, James. One, I talked to Congressman Glenn Grothman, and he felt, and I'm paraphrasing, this was a calculated move by the congressman from northeastern Wisconsin. So I'm asking you, James, if it's a calculated move, what's the motive?
Well, the motive is to send a message. It's the horse's head in the bed. It's hanging sort of Damocles over the House of Representatives, the Republican Party there, leaving them with only one vote margin. He's sending them a message that he thinks that the process is broken there. And by resigning on April 19th, he's making sure that Republicans can't just pick up that seat again until November. They have to wait until then to try to pick up that seat. And in November, of course, the election will be a lot more competitive than it is if it would be a special election now.
I've asked Congressman Gallagher this question before, and I was disappointed in his initial reaction January 6th to what he eventually decided to do down the road. There was a significant disconnect. He was one of the first people to actually go live on CNN and talk about the outrage. I think he said something like, "This is not a banana republic." Were you equally disappointed in sort of the about face or reversal of opinion by Congressman Gallagher when it came to sort of looking at some of the things that happened on January 6th and post November 2024 or 2020 rather?
I've been really disappointed in him for a while. And certainly if you go from what his statement on January 6th, when he made such a strong statement against Donald Trump and his behavior downward since his stabbing of Liz Cheney in the back, and his refusal to vote for the impeachment of President Donald Trump, Mike Gallagher promised to be an independent voice up there in Green Bay for Wisconsin residents, and instead, he's been as typical of a congressman as you can get, including his exit. Unfortunately, his exit, he's going to go to Palantir, a defense contractor, which lobbied for the ban on TikTok. And so Gallagher gets it through his committee, gets it through the House of Representatives, and then how convenient, he goes to take a job at a company that was lobbying for that ban.
What do you make of the current edition of the House? We have another call to oust the speaker, this time, not surprisingly, Marjorie Taylor Greene, asking for a reconsideration of that important job. Is there a chance, and I asked Congressman Grossmith this question, and he had some concern that at some point, given unforeseen circumstances, or like Mike Gallagher, Congressman Gallagher, a planned or unplanned departure from the House, that the Republicans could actually lose their majority or lose any sort of power in crafting legislation?
Well, coming out of the break, when they come back from their little spring break, Speaker of the House, Mike Johnson, is going to take up the Ukraine bill right away, and that is going to possibly force Marjorie Taylor Greene's hand. The way she filed the motion, it's not a privileged motion, so it doesn't have to be taken up by the House of Representatives. But she can change it to a privileged motion and force the House of Representatives to consider whether or not they want to have Mike Johnson as Speaker. And we may literally have a case where the Democrats come and bail out Mike Johnson to keep him as Speaker of the House, just to keep things moving and to keep legislation moving and give him the vote cushion that he needs, or enough Republicans may turn right around and make Hakeem Jeffries Speaker of the House in order to get some things done. It's a very, very interesting situation right now with that very narrow margin for error.
I made the point on the show last week that some of these concerns that some Congress people are exercising, decision to leave, Ken Buck's another congressperson that's sort of disgusted with the process, signal and match to some degree voters' concern about the insanity of some of the defenses made of the former president, Donald Trump, some of the concerns about the process of governing that many of us have spoken about, not just radio hosts, but just the general public, concerns that we're losing our minds over the politics of governing and not necessarily the policies that make sense to move our country forward. Do you share some of those concerns?
I definitely have some real concerns when the House of Representatives is showing the dysfunction that it's showing. And we've actually seen a case in the long term, if you take a look at it, where the Congress, the House of Representatives, and the Senate have slowly but surely been abandoning their duties and just placing more and more responsibilities with the executive branch, making more decisions to have the executive branch decide things rather than have the legislative process work. And as a result, our congressmen right now are nothing more than lobbyists trying to lobby different segments of the executive branch to get things done. And that's not a way that we envision the government should work. The people that are supposed to be in the Congress are supposed to be representing us and working with each other on compromises to create legislation that get things accomplished. And we're not seeing that right now.
What impact do you think, and we're going to break here in a second, we're talking to James Wigderson, what impact do you think Gallagher's departure is going to have on the makeup of the Wisconsin congressional delegation? Could we see a Democrat in that seat, a different Republican, a non-MAGA Republican? What do you expect?
Well, it was a seat that was held by a Democrat not that long ago, and it's been held by Republicans that were conservative, but they weren't in the full Donald Trump mode, and they weren't in the crazy mode, let's put it that way. And I think that Mike Gallagher's replacement, though, is likely going to be a much more of a MAGA-type Republican. And what will be interesting to see is whether or not the polls change in this country and in the state. And if Donald Trump starts taking some hits to his popularity as people start remembering what happened 4 years ago, whether or not that'll have an effect on that seat, I hesitate to make a prediction there, but part of it is Democrats are going to have to do a better job of recruiting a candidate there than they did for U.S. Senate 2 years ago, for example.
James Wigginson, our guest on the Political Power Hour. Take a break here. James, how do folks find your great writing?
They can go to jameswigginson.com. They can click on the link there to become a member there and receive my newsletter that comes out every Monday and Thursday. And also, they can follow me on social media. I'm on TikTok. I'm also on Twitter and YouTube and Threads and whatever else is up there these days.
Every way to find him. And as I said before, he's one of the best political writers in the state. All right, we'll take a break here.
Tony Drake here from Drake & Associates. Big news! Our Retirement Ready radio show is moving to a new time slot. Catch us at noon every Saturday. At Drake & Associates, we craft tailor-made plans that not only meet your financial needs, but align seamlessly with your unique lifestyle. Tune in at noon on Saturdays and get retirement ready.
Drake & Associates LLC is an independent investment advisory firm that offers a variety of different investment vehicles. This commercial is provided for informational purposes only and should not be construed as individual investment advice. Drake & Associates LLC does not provide legal or tax advice.
Hey, it's WTMJ Steve's Committee for the Bath Authority. If your bath or shower is old, outdated, has mold, mildew, broken tiles, you don't want that. You got to call my friends at the Bath Authority. The Bath Authority provides the highest quality bathroom remodeling products, along with a world-class, best-in-class customer experience, I like to say. They're modern, durable tubs and showers designed with an exclusive high-tech polymer liner. What does that mean? Low maintenance, resistance to mold and mildew, that's a good thing. Easy to clean, who doesn't like that? And lasts for decades, yes, decades. You're their priority at the Bath Authority. TheBathAuthority.com. A better bath awaits.
We find the best way to protect and uphold the reputation of our business is to hire good people and then take care of them. We really do love the people that work for us, and we care about what's in their best interest. And what that means to you is this. Who do you really want on your job? Someone who's maybe underpaid or doesn't feel appreciated? Might not have paid vacations or great work benefits? Our folks have all of these things and more. Vito and I make sure they feel appreciated because happy people do happy work. There's a culture we're building here at Semper Fi that brings respect back to a very hard job. And that's why we know that our crews are going to do the kind of work that you expect. This is Brad Youngbluth with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company. For your new roof, siding, window and door installation, or masonry work, you can count on Semper Fi to keep you safe, warm, and dry.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
Continue our conversation with writer, political writer James Wigginson on the Political Power Hour on WTMJ. James, Election Day coming up. Two questions on the ballot have to do with a phrase that's tossed around a lot, Zuckerbucks, and a second one on the sort of the process and the review of the election in Wisconsin. Your thoughts on the constitutional amendment questions in front of voters on April 2nd.
Right, and I can't seem to get anybody on the Republican side of the aisle to tell me one case of vote fraud that either of those right. amendments would prevent. And it's been frustrating. I sympathize with the goals of the amendments, but they could have been handled as bills. And the excuse that I'm getting is that Governor Evers will someday veto the bills if that was the route that the legislative Republicans were to take in this state. And my answer to that is if you put it into a package and you make a compromise with the governor where you give the local municipalities the money that they need to modernize their election systems so they don't have to rely on outside funding to pay for computer upgrades and things like that, then you can go ahead and you could probably get a bill passed with the governor's signature on it. That's not what this is about. This is totally about the Republican Party appeasing a base of crazies that still believe the 2020 election was stolen, and it was stolen by Mark Zuckerberg and Facebook somehow. And what they need to do is they need to instead address these minor things. They're so minor as legislation, not amend the state constitution. The state constitution is a basic governing document of the state, not a set of laws and regulations on how to do the little things.
Yeah, the minutia they're trying to put into the constitution seems silly to me.
Right, and they're doing it solely to get around the governor and solely to appease to their base. And what's disappointing to me is that you have, you know, people that you and I respect, like Will Flanders and Rick Essenberg, out there promoting these amendments too. When Will Flanders' own study on the 2020 election showed that the Zuckerbucks had such a minimal effect on the election, and it's not even worth addressing. And like I said, nobody can point to a case of fraud that occurred because of the Zuckerbucks, and nobody can point to any way that these amendments will prevent fraud in the future. So why are we doing this?
Do you think these amendments will go forward?
I think that there's a good chance that they will pass. I mean, they sound relatively reasonable. And
the second one is incredibly vague.
The second one has to do with the personnel,
yeah,
and whether or not the funding can pay for outside people to come in and help with elections. And it is incredibly vague. In fact, the first time I read it, I was like, "So are they banning right, people from volunteering to work at the polls?"
Yeah.
But I mean, what they're proposing is—I mean—it's on the level of whether or not we should be buying a ham sandwich for every member that works for at polls. I mean, is it maybe a good idea that they all get a ham sandwich that day? But do we have to put it in the state constitution? And it's ridiculous. And there is such bigger threats. That's the sad part about this. There are such bigger threats to our election integrity than these two little issues. And if these two little issues don't pass now, we're going to have a whole bunch of Republicans at the end of the 2024 process claiming that this election or that election got stolen because, once again, dark money suddenly invaded our election system.
Maybe we'll close with this one, since you and I have talked about this before, but and this certainly is shaped by all the things we've been talking about this half hour. If Trump loses again in November, and I think there's still a pretty good possibility that happens. I know what polls are suggesting, but you know, polls will change probably dramatically between now and November. Do you expect more or less of what I call the real shenanigans, the elected officials making fools of themselves because of a candidate that didn't win that they wanted to see win, or less?
I think that you will see more, actually. You will see more conspiracy theories. You'll see more scaremongering about what's going to happen because Donald Trump lost. Here's the problem that you have is that you don't have any adults left in the room anymore in the Republican Party to say that this is nonsense. I mean, I remember former Assembly Majority Leader Jim Steinke the day after the election saying, "No, really, Donald Trump lost, and this is why." And he's gone now. You know, Robin Voss has been appeasing the nuts all along, even though they've been trying to get rid of him. you just don't have anybody saying anymore that the conspiracy theories are nuts and they're not worth even listening to. And you're just going to have more of it if Donald Trump loses. And they're going to blame it on all the criminal charges against him and the civil suits and everything else. And they're going to say it was a grand conspiracy to prevent Donald Trump from becoming president again.
A man with opinions, which I appreciate, James Wiederson, strong political writer. How do folks find your great work, James?
They can go to jameswiederson.com, and like I said, they can just click on the little button that says become a member, and it'll give you the information on how to subscribe to my twice weekly newsletter.
We'll talk to you again in a couple of weeks. Back with the Political Power Hour on WTMJ after this.
Woo! Hey, this is Ben Brust from Kyle Brust and Ortman on ESPN Wisconsin. People can't stop screaming about the Screamin' Sicilian Frozen Pizza, and no wonder. There's plenty to scream about, like the buttery stone-fired crust, secret recipe tomato sauce, mounds of whole milk mozzarella, and tons of premium toppings. Find Screamin' Sicilian in your local grocer's freezer and find out for yourself why Sports called Screamin' Sicilian's Holy Pepperoni Frozen Pizza the best of the best. Screamin' Sicilian. Taste what all the screaming is about.
Hey, this is WTMJ Steve's Committee for Universal Windows Direct. I've been telling you that windows from Universal perform better and last longer. That is true. Super Spacer technology is one of the reasons. Keeps the edge of the glass warmer, holds the window seal longer, and makes the windows last up to 5 times longer than other window systems. Let's talk about some of the other great things that Universal offers. You can get almost a new home at the same address with vinyl siding for Universal Windows Direct. Exclusive Unishield Supreme siding delivers the warm, quality appearance of wood without the costly time-consuming maintenance repairs. It won't rot, peel, or split. And because it's color blended in the panel, it never needs to be scraped, stained, or painted. Tell them I told you to call. Get an additional $250 off your project for the last windows you'll ever need. Go to UniversalWindowsDirect.com. Like me, you'll be saying, I love my windows.
Home to the Auto Show, Tattoo Fest, RV Show, and more. Milwaukee's top trade and consumer shows belong at Baird Center. They make it easy, from a walkable downtown location to over 20 loading docks and a newly expanded exhibit hall, ensuring your exhibitors and attendees have an unforgettable visit. There's never been a better time to bring your next event downtown. Baird Center, Milwaukee's home for trade shows in the heart of the city. Learn more today at BairdCenter.com/planners. That's BairdCenter.com/planners.
Getting 10% back is easy at Fleet Farm. For a limited time only, Fleet Rewards members can earn 10% back on all purchases in-store and online. Spend $50, get $5 back in rewards. No rebates, no coupons, no hassles. Plus, Fleet Rewards membership is free. So if you're not signed up yet, now's the time. Then get shopping to earn 10% back on everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm. Some exclusions apply. Not valid at Ankeny and Waukee, Iowa stores.
AccuNet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about AccuNet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several $1,000s over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
Busy half hour. It continues next half hour. Not only do we have Dan Schaefer, a political writer, leaning left from the Democratic side of the aisle, but also special guest, a former mayor of New Orleans, Mitch Landrieu, will join us. He's the co-chair of the Biden re-election campaign. He's going to join us from somewhere in Wisconsin. They're talking about infrastructure and a whole lot more. So that's the next half hour as you tune in and listen to the Political Power Hour on WTMJ. Don't forget, tomorrow, Annie's off. So I got a special, sort of a special edition of the Political Power Hour. Our news time, citing unlimited news time, is 9:30. Here is the latest from ABC News.
This is a special report from ABC News. Baltimore bridge collapse. I'm Sherry Preston. Maryland Governor Wes Moore says it was a power outage on that large cargo ship that caused it to ram into the key bridge over Baltimore Harbor.
We can confirm that the crew notified authorities of a power issue.
The governor going on to say that once power was lost, the warning went out.
No, once the warning came up and once notification came up that there was a mayday, who literally, by being able to stop cars from coming over the bridge, these people are heroes. They saved lives last night.
As to the people who fell from the bridge inside their vehicles, Maryland Transportation Secretary Paul Wiedefeld has the numbers.
A total of 8, one rescued and in hospital, one not in hospital, but it is, we have communicated with that person, and then 6 that we are searching for.
This is ABC News.
Signing Unlimited, WTMJ News Times 931. A Texas man dies after getting stuck in a municipal water tank in western Wisconsin over the weekend. Our partners at TMJ4 News report 30-year-old Carlos Medina was cleaning from inside the tank in Blair, Wisconsin for over 45 minutes. He told his co-workers he was getting cold. Medina continued work. Then his co-workers believe he entered a hypothermic state. They were unable to pull him out of the water. First responders later arriving and were able to take Medina out of the water, but he later died after failed life-saving measures. The Fond du Lac County Sheriff's deputy who shot a man last year will not face charges. Investigators say Deputy Blaine Evans involved in a chase with Kyle Massey, who was being investigated for sexual assault in October. As he ran away after an exchange of gunfire, authorities later determined he died by suicide. Evans' canine also shot and injured during the incident and is still recovering. And Muskego police need the public's help locating individuals destroying mailboxes in the Big Muskego Estate subdivision and along Old Loomis Drive. Police are asking for any photos or home camera footage from Saturday, March 23rd between 2 and 4 a.m. Time for news about your money, the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. At this hour, the Dow is up 62 points to 39,376, while the S&P 500 is up 10 to 5,228, and the NASDAQ up 36 points to 16,421. It's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. Go to annexwealth.com and click on the Get Started button now. Checking the roads, your WTMJ Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic. Still working on clearing up the incident on 94 East at Mitchell Boulevard, that crash, blocking up traffic through the stadium. It has cleared up a bit, and it's nice and easy sailing through there now. Also, delays on 894 West from west of Loomis towards Forest Home are starting to alleviate through that construction zone as well. And 43 South looking like a nice ride, too, through that construction. No major incidents or delays there either. And your WTMJ forecast for today. Rain likely this afternoon. Could hear some rumbles of thunder as well with a high of 54. Gusty winds up to 40 miles per hour. Mostly cloudy tonight, down to 26. Clear Wednesday and Thursday. Highs in the mid-40s. Chance of rain late Friday. 45 near the lake. 54 inland. Morning rain possible Saturday and 48 degrees. Right now in Sturgeon Bay, light rain and 44. Menominee Falls, some showers in 49. And in Milwaukee, cloudy skies and 51 degrees. I'm Adam Roberts, Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Times 934.
Skilled trade workers are the backbone of every community and also the Army National Guard. Soldiers train to keep the power flowing, engines running, and in every other trade needed to accomplish the mission. These soldiers are on the fast track to learning skills that can set them up for success at home with companies looking to hire the best. Their resumes are being built through their paid training and part-time service. Find out how you too can learn a trade profession by visiting NationalGuard.com. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Army National Guard. Aired by the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association and this station.
Hey, this is WTMJ's Steve Cooper for Annex Wealth Management. If you're tired of sales pitches, when it comes to your investment retirement planning, how about a breath of fresh air? Annex Wealth Management is a diverse and talented team that provides guidance with no products to sell, zero commissions. Their commercials don't end with disclaimers about insurance products sold under separate companies. Investment and retirement planning can be complicated, but here's the deal. Annex can handle all of that. They'll create a plan that factors in Social Security, your pension if you have one, IRAs, 401ks. Let's not forget about taxes, that time of year, right? Year-round tax planning is a key factor in the success of your plan, especially now. It's time for a plan built by fiduciaries, not someone selling insurance disguised as financial advice. Annex Wealth Management is ready to assist for investment and retirement planning, tax planning, and estate planning. Know the difference. Start at annexwealth.com.
Good Karma Brands is proud to be an equal opportunity employer. Our policy is to provide equal opportunity employment, development, and advancement to all current and potential teammates. If you are an organization that maintains a job bank, provides employment information, or gives job referrals, you may request to be placed on the station's mailing list for future career opportunities. To learn more about careers at Good Karma Brands, please email careers@goodkarmabrands.com.
All right, round two. Actually, we have a special guest joining us as well. Mitch Landrieu, the former mayor of New Orleans, is going to join us in a little bit. So I got some moments with Dan Schaefer here. Hi, Dan.
Hi, Steve. How are you?
You are the creator and writer, chief writer, the only writer for the recombobulation area.
We have some other writers, too.
Oh, but do you really?
We have some contributors as well. And
special contributors.
That's right. That's
all right. Let's talk about the constitutional questions that are going to be facing us on the ballot next Tuesday, if you haven't already voted. The first one is really, it's fairly straightforward. Use of private funds in election administration, commonly referred to by conservatives as Zuckerbucks. Your thoughts?
Yeah, so I wrote a column about this at the Recombobulation Area last week, and the title of the column was that it's good in theory, bad in practice, and worse in process. So here's how that works. So this statewide constitutional amendment, and there will be important races on the ballot, up and down the ballot in every corner of Wisconsin. This one will be on all ballots across the state. So really important issue that touches every corner of the state here, these constitutional amendments. So the first one is asking whether we should ban private funds from election administration. On its face, it seems like a pretty good idea. We should, you know, keep these funded by public dollars. We should keep this a public process, all of that. If you look under the hood on this at all, you see that this is totally an issue that is driven by the election-denying conspiracy theorists who use terms like Zuckerbucks, right? So this is, there has been, you know, it's been endlessly proven that the 2020 election was free, fair, and secure. And so this issue is really, you know, it's not an issue that's going to solve any actual problems, because if we wanted to solve a problem, you could go to the legislature and pass a bill that has funding for election administration.
You and I know that's the process, but that's not how it's playing out in Wisconsin.
That's not how it's playing out, because Republicans refuse to work with Democrats on this. They refuse to pass a bill that Tony Evers might actually sign. The bills that they passed to do this had no Democratic votes, and Tony Evers signed it in 2021. So instead of going back to the drawing board and passing something in a bipartisan way, they're trying to go around that and use these referendum questions that are worded so confusingly that it's hard to know even what they're saying. But we should not be in the business of letting election deniers rewrite the state constitution.
All right, that's question number one. We're going to take a break. After the break, we're going to be joined by Mitch Landrieu. He's the former mayor of New Orleans. He's in Wisconsin today working on behalf of the Biden-Harris. He's actually the campaign co-chair. We'll have that conversation. Infrastructure in Wisconsin is the one of the topics, but we'll get to some other things as well. That's coming up next on the Political Power Hour on WTMJ.
Join veteran political strategists Donna Brazile and Anna Navarro on April 9th for an animated political discussion at UWM Waukesha. Donna Brazile is a New York Times bestselling author, former interim chair of the DNC, and ran Al Gore's presidential campaign in 2000. Anna Navarro was national co-chair of John McCain's Hispanic Advisory Council and worked on his 2008 campaign. Presented by the Tommy G. Thompson Center on Public Leadership, a political evening with Donna Brazile and Anna Navarro at UWM Waukesha. Learn more at uwm.edu/politics2024.
Hey, this is WTMJ Steve's Committee for Adair Floors, ADAIR. That's how you can look it up. Floors and remodeling, by the way, South 27th Street in Franklin. Been in business for 65 years. I've used them on multiple projects. Their design team, I just worked with them on my basement landing area, can help with all your flooring and remodeling needs, home or business. Family owned and operated. That matters, folks. Right there in Franklin, South 27th Street, south of Rawson, north of Highway 100, also known as Ryan Road. Stop in. Tell them Scafidi sent you. They're always nice. They'll be extra nice. Visit them online, adairfloors.com.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercure here for one of my favorite places. The Fox and Hound Supper Club is the most unique, beautiful, and affordable dining destination in the area. Winners of the Top Choice Award for Fine Dining, Most Romantic Restaurant, and Best Sunday Brunch. When you buy one dinner, your second dinner is free always, 7 nights a week. Steak, seafood, ribs, pasta, big fresh salad, even the steak and lobster. Any dinner on the menu, your second dinner is free. That includes prime rib on Wednesdays and Saturdays. Desserts are also always buy one, get one free, and they're delicious. Relax with a hand-muddled old-fashioned, 20 bourbons, 100 wines, and one of their 8 elegant dining rooms. The Fox and Hound sits in the Kettle Moraine Forest, a spectacular setting. Celebrate a birthday, anniversary, or a quiet dinner with your love, and your second dinner is free. Just off Highway 167, 2 miles east of Holy Hill, the drive is beautiful. Reserve at foxandhoundsrestaurant.com for your free dinner. Tonight, it's the Fox and Hounds.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
SemperFiRoofing.com.
You can't beat Burkhart.
New Berlin and Fox Point.
Wait now or wait a little longer. You may have just increased your lifetime income by tens of thousands of dollars. That's how Social Security can work for you. The longer you wait, the more money you may get. Deciding when to start taking your Social Security benefits is one of the most important retirement decisions you'll make. Our team at Drake & Associates can show you the options and help make the right decision for your situation. You spent decades paying in. Optimize what comes out. Drake & Associates can help you squeeze every penny out of your Social Security benefits. Claim your free Retirement Ready Toolkit that has guides on Social Security. To get our complimentary toolkit, call or text SS to 414-409-9982. That's calling or texting SS to 414-409-9982.
Investment advisory services provided by Drake & Associates, LLC, an SEC registered investment advisor. Insurance products are offered through a separate company, Loft Financial Advisory Group, LLC, a Wisconsin insurance agency. Clients are under no obligation to purchase any recommended insurance products.
Yours truly, Dan Schaefer, joining me as he does every Tuesday. He writes the Recombobulation Area, of course, area. Also, that famous sign hanging at Mitchell Field, which I see pictures of all the time on social media.
Yeah, it's become a thing. Every time
it's kind of cool.
Every time one of our readers is traveling, they got to tweet a picture at me.
That's got to be a nice feeling because, I mean, you've sort of created this enterprise reporting on politics, but yet you have that kind of fun side of it.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think it's, you know, it shows how committed our readers are. If they're taking time out of their day, they're holding their kids, getting through that crazy security line, taking time to take that photo.
We got a little bit of time. We're on standby for Mitch Landrieu, who's the co-chair of the Biden-Harris campaign in Wisconsin. He's in the state talking about infrastructure. But let's get to question number two, basically asking about the process and administration of elections. How do you see that one?
Yeah, I think this is another very problematic question. And I think it, again, centers around, you know, another conspiracy theory from the 2020 election, talking about, you know, an individual who worked with that foundation founded by Mark Zuckerberg, who was working at the polling place in Green Bay. Again, this is just a nonsense question. We should not be amending the state constitution to cater to the thoughts of election deniers.
And we will circle back on that one. Right now, we are joined by Mitch Landrieu, former mayor of New Orleans, mayor to mayor, sort of an unofficial mayor to mayor conversation, who's in the state on behalf of the Biden-Harris reelection campaign. Good morning, Mayor.
Hey, Mayor, how you doing?
I am good. So tell us why you're in the state of Wisconsin. We're also joined by Dan Schaefer here in the studio.
Well, the real reason I'm here is I'm hustling votes for Joe Biden and to save democracy in America. And I came to the great state of Wisconsin to, you know, get around and talk to folks about the incredible record that President Biden has and the failed presidency of Donald Trump. So I'm here today. I was in Madison. I just rolled into Racine. I'll be heading to La Crosse and to Wausau tomorrow. The president was here just a couple of weeks ago delivering on a promise to help rebuild the infrastructure. And of course, you know, he's been here nine times. He announced not too long ago a $1 billion investment to rebuild the Blatnik Bridge on the other side of the state. And as a consequence of his policies, has sent billions of dollars here to rebuild the lives of the people of Wisconsin. So I just came to highlight that, and I'm looking forward to meeting with all the folks that I'm supposed to meet with. I just pulled up to a transit system that has received one of the largest amounts to have electric buses to make sure that we have clean air for our kids and our workers who are driving. And we'll continue to highlight those issues and, of course, remind people that Donald Trump didn't deliver anything for Wisconsin like he said he was.
Let me ask you this. How do you motivate voters when it's sort of a replay of 2020? How do you get people enthusiastic, excited about this upcoming election in November?
Well, first of all, it's not a replay at all. Every election is different. We are 4 years, 3 years into the Biden administration. As you noted, I had the great honor of helping run the infrastructure investment program where the president delivered $1.2 billion $1.2 trillion in investments to rebuild the roads and the bridges. That money has gotten to the ground. You've seen a presidency working where Joe Biden shows up every day trying to help other people, lift other people up, bring people together. And you remember the failed presidency of Donald Trump, who basically lost 2.5 million jobs. Joe Biden gained 15.5 million. Donald Trump lost tens of thousands of manufacturing jobs. Joe Biden has created 800,000 of them. We now have the longest run of the lowest unemployment in the last 50 years. And, of course, Wisconsin is benefiting from Joe Biden's presidency. Donald Trump promised a lot of stuff, never delivered on any of it. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot. I apologize. He delivered a tax cut for the wealthiest 1% of Americans, his friends, and for the big corporations. And Joe Biden has been doing the exact opposite of making sure that there's money in the pocket of working men and women, especially, by the way, men and women that work in unions. I was thrilled today to hear the news in Wisconsin that the utilities have signed a deal with the unions to rebuild all the renewable energy construction projects that are coming from the Inflation Reduction Act. They're going to create another 30,000 jobs in Wisconsin as well.
Mr. Landra, you said you've done a lot, like you mentioned, you've done a lot of work on infrastructure. And I think one of the president's signature achievements is that bipartisan infrastructure law. But that's not a typical campaign issue, infrastructure. How do you see that as motivating voters in this election?
Well, first of all, you're right. It's not the only one, but it is a major one. Remember, presidents for 50 years talked about rebuilding the country. You can't have a strong economy without strong infrastructure. So we can't just dance by the fact that Joe Biden did something that the last five presidents couldn't do. But you're right. It's not the only issue. Giving tax breaks to the wealthy at the expense of working men and women, that's a big issue. Joe Biden is going to fight for the little guy. He's going to fight against the pharmaceutical industry. He's going to make sure your prescription drug costs are low. He's going to make sure your student debt is taken care of. On women's rights to control their own bodies and reproductive freedom, this is a really clear issue. Donald Trump is absolutely responsible, because he brags about it, for the reversal of Roe versus Wade and returning the issue of women's rights to the states, which we've now seen what states are going to do, like Alabama, who are outlawing IVF, and then are coming after contraception next, or taking away the Affordable Care Act, which Donald Trump continues to threaten. Joe Biden is going to protect health care for Americans, because we think it's a right, not a privilege. And then finally, just on real meat and potato stuff, jobs and the cost of living, Joe Biden is in there fighting every day for the folks that work with their hands every day. And Trump is taking care of his friends that are making mailbox money every day.
Biden campaign co-chair Mitch Landrieu, former mayor of New Orleans, is joining us on WTMJ Political Power Hour. How much will your campaign be talking about election integrity going forward till November?
Well, first of all, the 2020 was one of the safest elections in the history of the country. The rest of that noise is just garbage. It's been debunked every time, everywhere, by anyone who's looked at any of it. And so we are 100% in favor of giving more people the right to vote in the safest way possible, because I don't know if people remember this, but Joe Biden kicked Donald Trump's butt 4 years ago, 8 million more votes, and he's going to do it again. He's actually the only guy that's beat Donald Trump. So all these people that say Joe Biden can't beat Donald Trump, I mean, I don't know what they're looking at, but Joe Biden's the only guy that's ever beat him, and he's going to beat him again. Absolutely important that we have safe and honest elections. The last election was one of the most safe, honest elections that we have had. The problem is Donald Trump's a whiny baby, and he got beat, and he just doesn't want to admit that he got beat, and he's a loser, and he's a failure. And that's just a fact. He just is. And, you know, to make all those other excuses about whatever, you know, is just a bunch of bunk. And every court that's looked at all of these allegations, you know, have debunked them. The election was won fair and square, and Joe Biden's going to beat him again, just like he did 4 years ago.
So we have a primary here in Wisconsin 1 week from today. There's not a lot of intrigue about who's going to win that primary, of course, but a number of people in Wisconsin are encouraging people to vote uninstructed in that primary. What is your message to those voters?
Well, listen, I think President Biden thinks that everybody ought to, you know, exercise their First Amendment right to talk about whatever issue is important to them. And there are lots of different issues that people want to use. At the end of the day, though, in November, when the chips are down and the future of democracy is at stake, there will be two choices. And the choice is really clear. You can vote for a guy that wakes up and thinks about himself and his rich friends and wants to use revenge and retribution and use his power to hurt people and to take us back to a time when only a couple of people in America got the benefit of the promise of America. Or you can vote for a guy, Joe Biden, who wakes up every day thinking about other people, including other people, and believes that our best days ahead and believe that we can build big things together. You've got a guy that's got the receipts of showing people what that looks like, or you got a guy that just talks and basically loses jobs. And I think on that day, when that decision is made, I think most Americans of goodwill, even those people who voted for Donald Trump, are going to go, that guy hoodwinked me, told me he was going to do something, and actually turned it to dirt, which is what happens with everything that he touches. and that Joe Biden's a decent, good guy who worked hard, put people back to work, and put America on the right track. And I believe that the people of Wisconsin, the good people of Wisconsin, are going to do the right thing.
Mayor, hope we can talk down the road before the November election. Thanks for taking the time to join us.
You got it, Matt. Thanks so much for talking to you.
Absolutely.
God bless you.
Former Mayor of New Orleans, Mitch Landrieu, now the co-chair of the Biden-Harris campaign. We'll take a break here. We'll wrap it up with Dan Schaefer after this on the Political Power Hour, WTMJ.
I'm Sandy Max, host of WTMJ's What's on Tap. Weeknights at 6, you're invited to join me for conversations about culture and creativity in Wisconsin and around the world.
Well, for the first time ever, we are serving St. Patrick's Cream Puff.
Discover and rediscover music, theater, film, food, and topics that are unique to our state.
As of today, we've announced that Milwaukee Film will be taking over Operation at the Downer.
It's your hour-long escape from the ordinary. What's on Tap on WTMJ and wherever you get your podcasts.
Hey, this is WTMJ, Steve's here for Advent. I told you about it, tossing and turning. That does not have to be your reality. Poor sleep, tired mornings. I didn't want to deal with that anymore. I did something about it. I was a customer before I was a spokesperson. I went to Advent, quick 30-minute visit. They put me at ease, answered all my questions. We did a really simple sleep study at home in my own bed. They determined my problem, sinuses, nasal passages, in my breathing triangle. After a short procedure done in office, I'm back to breathing as well as I ever have, sleeping through the whole night, rested, refreshed. That could be your reality. If you struggle like we did, take the time to see how Advent can help you to find out how breathing well and sleeping well can make your nights better. Go to AdventKnows.com and schedule an appointment today, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Visit family-owned Ken Michaels Furniture and our in-store design centers, where you'll still find beautiful, luxurious, heirloom quality American-made furniture. Right now, save 30 to 35% store-wide and take advantage of our complimentary design services. Whether you're moving, renovating, or updating, our designers will help your vision become a reality. Visit Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield on Capitol Drive and in Greenfield on Highway 100 to save 30 to 35% store-wide today. Stop into Ken Michaels Furniture for our sale on Bradington Young. Made in the foothills of the Great Smoky Mountains, Bradington Young is an American icon in quality leather upholstery. Whether you are looking for a power recliner or stationary seating, BY's furniture is made with enduring quality, outstanding comfort, and timeless styling. Save 35% now on Bradington Young Upholstery at Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield and Greenfield. Visit us today.
Uline is here for the hard workers, for the ones rolling up their sleeves, working round the clock, and getting the job done. You're dedicated to doing what it takes to keep a business growing. Uline is dedicated to helping you make that happen. Working 7 days a week, staying fully stocked and ready to ship any of our 41,000 items the same day. Uline, your shipping and industrial supply specialists. Visit uline.com.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee. From the Annex Wealth Management Studios, this is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
Last couple minutes with my guest, writer Dan Schaefer. How can folks find your great work?
You can find it at therecombobulationarea.news. You can find the Recombobulation Area publishing on Substack. And you can find me on Twitter at Dan R. Schaefer, where I am occasionally tweeting about things other than the Milwaukee Bucks.
All right, let's circle back on the questions on the ballot. I spent a half hour with conservative writer James Wigerson earlier. He also thinks these things are a train wreck and a mess, poorly written, vague. Just some final thoughts on what we're being asked to vote on next Tuesday.
Yeah, I think we should, if this is an issue that we want to address, and I think it is one that we should address, we should do it in the legislature and not by amending the state constitution to appease those who take terms like Zuckerbucks seriously.
It seems gimmicky to me.
Yeah.
And it's not the place for that.
Well, and it seems like they clearly set this up thinking that there was going to be, a competitive primary. This is a get out the base thing. This is appease the Trump MAGA base that is so into these election denier conspiracy theories. And now we're here and it's not a competitive primary. And I really think it's important for people to vote no on this. I think it's no surprise that so many, nonpartisan groups, League of Women's Voters, Conservation Voters, Wisconsin Democracy Campaign, all of those different kinds of groups are lining up against this. And that seems to say something to me.
I know you're not usually in the prediction business. What's your sense on those?
You know, I think last year when we had Janet Protasiewicz won the landslide election, we had two constitutional amendments advanced by Republicans also both pass. So I think it's really a tough one. Most of those constitutional amendments that have been on the referendum for voters, I think 9 out of the last 10 have passed. So I would probably lean towards expecting it to pass, but you never know.
Yeah, and this is sort of a out of the... I don't know how to describe this. I think one might pass. The first one might pass because Zuckerbucks has been talked about a lot. The second one, it seems so vague, and I know I've used that term a lot, but that's how I read it. And sort of such a micro process question, it doesn't belong in a constitutional amendment, in my opinion.
It seems to just be written by lawyers who want to be hyper litigious
right.
about the next election cycle, which I don't think is something we want in Wisconsin either. We had that in 2020. That was not fun.
Hey, real quick, what do you think the turnout's going to be?
I think it'll be relatively low. So since we don't have, you know, a statewide election, I think here in Milwaukee, we, you know, because we don't really have competitive races for mayor, for county executive, I don't think turnout is going to be, you know, higher than some past spring elections. Certainly nothing like last year.
And let me scold non-voters. Every election's important. I know you have busy lives. We all do. But it takes a moment, and you can early vote. You can get your ballot sent to you in the mail. There's no excuse, really. All of these things matter. Take the time. Show up. Vote. Give your elected leaders your thoughts on how our government, which I know you all have thoughts about, how you're feeling when you vote. Dan Schaefer, we'll do it again next Tuesday.
Thank you, Steve.
All right. The news is next on WTMJ.
I'm Jim Token, president of the Auto Dealers Association of Metro Milwaukee. There are so many reasons to service your car or truck and buy your next vehicle at one of the 115 ATOM member dealers. ATOM dealers employ more than 7,500 people in southeastern Wisconsin, which helps support thousands of local families.